Hi guys, welcome back to Toon Lee's channel here in Thailand, and today it's a bit of an update for you, something a little bit new. Not an update on Caesar, had enough of him for a little while. An update on the solar. What's been happening is quite a few people that are fairly new to the channel have been looking at the videos from our early days and spotted that we had solar installed many moons ago, I think about 9 or 10 months ago. So a few were asking how we've been getting on with it. Right, so solar, is it any good? Do we regret putting it in? Was it good value for money? Is there anything we would change or anything broken, anything like that? Well, the good news is nothing's broken on it at all. Nothing has been broken. And everything's working as it should do. The solar panels at the top, no issues at all. We still get the odd pigeon trying to nest underneath there, but it's a bit too hot for them, so they jog on quite quickly. We would like an extra couple of panels, but we'll talk about that a bit more in a bit. The solar room is cool enough, even in the middle of summer. We've got that heat reflected back in on the underside of the roofing sheet, so no dramas there. No one's tried to break in and steal our expensive batteries, so that's always good. Right, most expensive bit, the batteries. No issues at all. We've not had to top up any of them, so all 8 are running fine. They've never run low. A couple of the nipple indicators have dropped a tiny bit. We will top them up, but they're not at low level at the moment anyway, so it's just being a bit anal about it. Just want to point out at the bottom of your screen there, you'll see that white line underneath the batteries. The batteries aren't sitting on the concrete floor. A few people have misseen that and thought that they were straight on the concrete, which of course is a no-no for the batteries. So they're on foam crates. The back row of batteries there, the back four, are on a rack that was built for them. So the initial install, they were all in the line, which was wrong, and then they repositioned them like this, which has helped a great deal. Well, it's fixed any little gremlins we had. The inverter at the end there, brilliant piece of kit. The only thing that I would like different on it is I'd like the battery indicator to give you a proper indication, because it's either full or empty. At the moment everything's fine because we know the batteries are full, but when you get a few days of cloudy cover, it is a bit misleading. And we've got the hang of it, we can roughly gauge what sort of levels we've got, but that's by purely how much we're using. But it'd be nice to have an accurate readout. It'd be brilliant if we could have an accurate readout for each battery. That would be absolutely brilliant if we could do that, make sure that the whole system is charging each other. So that would help if we had individual indicators. The gump up here, we've had no issues with the fuse box or breaker, that's been working fine. So, on the whole, an absolute success. Now, if you haven't seen the original solar vlog, if you have a butcher's on there, I think it was 120 or 130,000 for the system. We haven't spent anything on it since then. We would like an extra couple of panels, and Toon did ring the installation guy that came to do it. He came out and said, yeah, I can sort that out for you. And then he didn't come back for a few days, which was a bit strange, and Toon rang. His missus answered the phone. The bloke had dropped dead, so gutted. A really, really nice bloke as well. Well, our whole family, absolute diamonds, but the good die young, don't they? So we haven't pushed for getting another 2 panels on there. We might have to look elsewhere to have that done. The reason we'd like 2 more panels is it's during the cloudy months. today's quite overcast, but we've had three or four really sunny days with hardly any cloud, so the batteries are all fully charged. But you get three or four days on the trot and then you need to use a fair bit of juice, they do drop quite quickly. So the things we've learned when we first installed, we were using everything. We just thought, oh, bloody free electric, let's have a go at that. So the water pump from the well was used to fill up the first four, well, the new four fish ponds. So it did all that without any issues. Pumping water out of the borehole, running an incubator 24/7, fridge with a freezer in there. Of course your lights and then your TV, laptop, phones, all that sort of thing, and the fans. We haven't got aircon, okay? That's a totally other subject, guys. You know, we don't need aircon. The house isn't hot from the roof system that we've got installed, so it's not an issue at all. What was I saying? Right, where was I? I went off at a tangent. Okay, so when it was first installed, we were definitely heavy users of electric. Then the cloudy weather came, and we were still trying to use the same amount of power. So if anything, guys, it was operator error or user error as far as the usage was going. We were just using too much power. The system could handle it, but the weather was restricting it. So what did we do? Well, we just cut down on what we used, really. The ponds were full by then, thank goodness, so there was hardly any pumping of water that was required. The big water tank was full up from the borehole. Then after the last lot of eggs were hatched from the incubator, we decided to hold fire until the sunnier weather. To get round when things were bombing out, when we had some welding done and that sort of thing, the system seems to be quite sensitive that way and trips out a lot. We've still got the old generator in this left-hand building, so we just ran that. What we did do a couple of times when my mum was here and we ran out of power in the middle of the night, we ran the generator to the solar system, so you can still use the whole system and it's charging your batteries back up at the same time. That works well. So is it worth it? Well, what I have found, and I've touched upon this on the previous solar videos, people seem to be really divided about solar. They're either singing its praises and they've got absolute blind faith, or they're totally anti and almost obtuse about the solar as an option, as an install. Of course, some people are sitting on the fence and somewhere in between. That's probably where me and Toon are. We wouldn't have installed solar if we could have hooked up into the grid. But the grid's almost 2 kilometres away, so we were quoted over 1 million baht from the PEA. So that was not an option. We didn't have that sort of funds available to do that. So I think, if I cast my mind back, it was 130,000 baht, or was it 120, one or the other. And then of course, don't forget, if you think about you replacing your batteries between 5 and 10 years, then that's 56,000 baht. So the money that you save in not paying an electrical bill every month, you need to be putting that away for your batteries in the future. Would we do it again? Definitely. There's no way we'd, even if we had the money available, no way we would have paid that money to hook up to the grid and then pay a bloody monthly fee on top of that. Not a chance. Since we've moved here, there's a few other buildings started to spring up, which we anticipated would occur. Once there's 5 new buildings in an area, then the PEA will put forward an application to put 3 electric all the way through. So in the future, we may well have the chance to do that, just to hook up to the main grid that the PEA have put in. if it doesn't happen, I don't feel that we need to expand the system. Yeah, a couple more panels wouldn't go amiss, but apart from that, really, really good. So there was the first thing that we were concerned about, the main thing that we were concerned about, living off-grid out here. I wouldn't say it's in the middle of nowhere, but with no amenities. Solar was a huge, huge worry for us. Well, for me, I did the worry in turn, not so much. But probably one of the best things, if not the best thing, that we've had installed. So I think the main bit of advice is go for more power than you think you need, more batteries than you think you need, more solar panels than you think you need, and then you'll probably just about get it right. Of course, we did have calculations done for us, and in the sunny months we've got more than enough power. But in the cloudy months we could have done with an extra couple of panels. In the future, solar wise, we're going to install an old pump that we've got from the old house, and run an old panel that was left here that the government installed many moons ago, and we're going to run that to the palms that Toon and I put in last month. So that won't be running off a battery. I believe it'll be just like a DC, a direct current, I think that's the phrase. So as soon as the light comes up, it can just pump water out the lake. Water in the lake is just amazing. And the volume and the levels, it's just, I think we'll just be able to pump water every single day of the week. Okay, I think that's it. Solar power. Love it, hate it, whatever. It works for us. We didn't have an option, but now we've got it. Can't really imagine living out here without it. I love it. Just don't expect too much and get your head round how best to use the power. Okay guys, as always, thanks for watching. Next update will be the borehole that we had installed about 6 months ago. Okay, ta-da for now.